I loved the book when I first read it. It's so eerie and so disturbing, and until about halfway through, you still really have no sense of what's going on. You just know that there's something wrong.
No one said anything about this. No one said anything about a locked gate.
Bruce, relax.
The story that he's told within this book is a story of humanity and a story of lost humanity and how necessary it is to be humane to your fellow man.
I'd like you to forgive me.
Forgive you for what?
It asks very difficult questions. It isn't comfortable. Yet it is also very, so really beautiful and makes you think. And I think that's actually quite rare.
There's two British novelists who I'm very aware of having been influenced by. One of them is J.G. Ballard, and the other one is Kazuo Ishiguro. And for a heavyweight literary novelist, which he is, you know, he's Booker Prize winning big shot, you know, he's the real deal. He's very approachable, he's very unassuming.
He really kindly gave us all signed first editions of the book as a start present, which was lovely. You know, I mean, I'd read Remains of the Day before anyway, and loved the film of that as well, actually. And I think his writing is beautiful. You know, it's so, I don't mean simple, it's not simple, but it seems like every word he's chosen is the perfect word.
Times over the years, when I've told myself I shouldn't look back so much. But there came a point when I just stopped resisting. I arrived in England from Japan as a five-year-old in 1960. My father was a scientist working for the British government at that time. And I didn't start to write fiction until relatively late. I had for many years great aspirations to be a singer-songwriter. And I did this whole thing of trying to become part of the music scene and failed miserably. But at a certain point in my life, around that age of kind of early 20s, I made the transition from writing songs to writing stories, and it felt very natural.
Often I read a book going, wow, could this be a film? And I didn't think about that as I read the book because I was so wrapped up in the story, but then I started wondering if it could be a film and was frankly kind of scared of the idea of making it into a film because I thought it was so delicate and strange. And yet I couldn't stop thinking about the challenge of it and the puzzle of if one were to make this into a film, how could you pull that off?
I have to admit, I wasn't familiar with Mark's work. So I went to look at the one movie that he had made at the time, which is 1 Hour Photo, starring Robin Williams. And I was very struck by it indeed. It had a tremendous energy. It had that same kind of repressed energy that I sometimes try to go for in my own writing.
I know what you think, Cathy. I know you think that you and Tommy would have made a more natural couple. You see, the thing is, Cathy, although Tommy really likes you as a friend, he just doesn't see you that way.
I suppose my strategy as a writer was not to show a beautiful, wonderful side of life, but I wanted to show life in all its complexities. I wanted to show that it is a struggle, but that essentially I wanted these three people to be essentially decent.
It had never occurred to me that our lives, which had been so closely interwoven, could unravel with such speed.